Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. One of the fastest growing business sectors in New Hampshire is renewable energy and clean technology. And that sector has been at odds with the New Hampshire Legislature this past session over funds that are used for renewable energy systems in both businesses and homes. Let's go to the graphic, and here is which shows the fastest growing industry in New Hampshire, at least one of them, renewable energy, clean tech, is solar, wind, wood pellets, and energy efficiency in particular. They employ up to 20,000 people in New Hampshire. Now, in the legislature, here's why this group has been at odds. The New Hampshire House and Senate raided a dedicated New Hampshire Renewable Energy Fund. It's around $52 million. And they also had an impasse over the use of carbon emission cap and trade funds, about $20 million in 2016. Why are these important to the business community? Because businesses can use both funds, and that is fueling growth. With me to talk about this is the Executive Director of the New Hampshire Clean Tech Council, Kate Epson. Welcome.
Hi, Fred.
And the co-founder and owner of Granite State Solar, Eric Shiflett. Welcome.
Thank
you. You're based in Boscawen.
Boscawen, New Hampshire.
Okay. Kate. What's the issue with this? What is the New Hampshire Renewable Energy Fund, and what's the issue?
This is a dedicated fund that was set up through our renewable portfolio standard to allow incentives to go out to businesses, homeowners, and towns to install renewable energy systems.
Okay, and that's a fund at the state level, and the money comes from?
It comes from all ratepayers.
All ratepayers, mm-hmm. Utilities.
And then utilities make payments into the fund.
Into the mm-hmm. fund. And the standard is to meet, what, 25%?
To get to 25% renewable energy resources of all electric retail sales by 2025.
Statewide.
Okay.
And Eric, you use this fund in your business. How do you do so?
That's right. Granite State Solar utilizes the renewable energy funds by passing them to consumers who are considering a solar purchase.
So, for instance, give me an example of how you use them and what difference it makes.
So, for a resident or a business owner of New Hampshire looking at the return on investment for their solar array, the fact that they're able to recoup some of that cost by utilizing the renewable energy fund reduces that time to return on investment. It's a powerful incentive. It's been a great investment in our company and in the industry as a whole, because we're finding that we're more competitive, we're more cost competitive, and the Renewable Energy Fund has, I think, helped get the industry off the ground and really put some wind in the sails.
Now, Kate, the New Hampshire House wiped that fund out completely, the Senate restored it, and then took some of it again. And the issue here is that it's a dedicated fund just for renewable energy, energy efficiency, and so forth, right?
That's correct, renewable energy only.
So you're calling this raid unconstitutional?
We have consulted with some top constitutional attorneys, yep. And that analysis had said it's likely illegal and it's against the state constitution.
Would you take the legislature to court over this?
We're still considering all of our options on mm-hmm. that front. I mean, this question has come up in many budgetary cycles because we're often hard-pressed to balance the budget. We have revenue shortages, and I understand it's a very tricky process,
right.
But it's happened time and again, so it feels somewhat ripe to ask the question of the courts.
Now, there's also a disagreement with the legislature between the clean tech industry in New Hampshire over the use of carbon emission cap and trade funds, around $20 million, $16 to $20 million a year. And what are those funds used for?
Those funds are used for energy efficiency projects.
Right.
So you can insulate your house, you can change out light bulbs, businesses can use them for new HVAC systems, new processing systems.
And what's the issue with that?
So the issue with that is there was a bill to use those auction proceeds to go back into more efficiency for towns and low-income sectors, and then all of the other money would get rebated to the commercial industrial sector as
yeah.
bill credits.
And its status right now is that the legislature is still negotiating as we do this interview on both of these issues, right?
Actually, they reached an impasse on the Reggie bill, so everything's going to stay at the status quo.
Okay. Eric, real quick, before we wrap up, what difference does all of this make to you as a business?
Well, it could, if the Renewable Energy Fund is raided, it could really put a damper on the growth of the industry. I mean, we're hiring right now. We have 14 employees. I think that puts us in a mid-sized business category, and we're anticipating future growth and planning on hiring for that. However, if business were to slow down because of a change in the business model and economics of the industry,
right.
That would be reflected in payroll.
Okay, and that renewable energy fund makes a difference. I want to thank you, Kate Epsom, Executive Director of New Hampshire Clean Tech Council, and Eric Shiflett, who is CEO or co-founder and owner of Granite State Solar. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for having us, Fred.
If you want to see this interview again, you go to WMUR.com, click on News, and then click on Project Economy.